हेलो गाइस, गुड इवनिंग। हाय,
सो
वीडियोस ऑन कर लो।
हाँ सब उस कर
Yes, before starting, I wanted to talk to you about a few things. Yes, first of all, look, we are already late in starting our course because it is already September, okay? And there is a lot of course that we have to complete. By say, I want to complete it by February, but it can go up till March also. But March, I want to end everything. Okay, so first of all, the most important thing is we cannot miss classes unless it's an emergency. Okay, so I know schoolwork is always keeping you busy, but you have to manage it somehow and you have to keep attending the classes and manage school at the same time. Yes. School will always keep you involved in something or the other, but you have to manage it. Okay? And if something happens, inform me beforehand so that I can plan it out. I can plan accordingly. Okay? It should not be at the last moment that, sir, we won't be able to come because something is happening. Okay? So, because we need to complete our course on time. एंड आई एम ट्राइंग माई बेस्ट कि अपना फेबरवरी तक खत्म हो जाए, बट लेट्स सी, वी हैव टू बी ऑन शेड्यूल, वी हैव टू बी डिसिप्लिन। ठीक है, सो डू नॉट मिस क्लासेस एनी मोर। एंड ऑफकोर्स अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट यू हैव टू कीप डूइंग योर होमवर्क ऑन टाइम। ठीक है, इफ यू आर डूइंग योर होमवर्क ऑन टाइम, यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड जो अपन आगे नेक्स्ट क्लास में कर रहे हैं, एवरीथिंग विल बी क्लियर। बट इफ यू आर नॉट डूइंग होमवर्क, इट विल पाइल अप एंड यू माइट मिस आउट ऑन सम टॉपिक्स बिकॉज यू आर डूइंग सम अदर वर्क, एंड देन इट विल पाइल अप एंड आफ्टर वर्ड्स व्हेन इट द एग्जाम्स कम अप देन इट विल स्ट्रेस सिचुएशन। ठीक है, डू नॉट डू दैट, डू योर होमवर्क एज एंड व्हेन आई टेल यू टू डू। ठीक है, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टूडेज क्लास। फर्स्ट मुझे ये बताओ कि फंक्शंस में कोई डाउट है क्या? हैव यू डन योर होमवर्क?
आई वेंट थ्रू द बुक, मेरे को कोई डाउट नहीं था.
वेंट थ्रू द बुक मीन्स सिर्फ पढ़ के क्वेश्चंस या फिर
नहीं
करे
सर,
हैं?
मैंने मैंने काफी ट्राई करे पर मैं सारे नहीं कर पाई सर, बिकॉज आवर स्कूल इज टेकिंग प्रैक्टिसेस फ्रॉम मॉर्निंग टू इवनिंग. यू कैन इवन आस्क अनन्या एवरी डे सर, मॉर्निंग टू इवनिंग
आई वेंट थ्रू द
क्लासेस.
बुक, आई विल जस्ट डू ईच एंड एवरी सम.
लाइक आई ट्राइड, लाइक फ्रॉम एवरी एक्सरसाइज आई ट्राइड फ्यू सम्स, बट आई कुडंट डू ऑल बिकॉज सुबह से शाम लाइक 10 बजे तक क्लासेस थी, दस
All
रात
right.
के 10 बजे तक.
Okay, I don't want, first of all, I don't want you to do every sum. Okay, you can leave the questions which are almost similar to each other. Theek hai? So, most of the times it is that you can do alternate questions. Theek hai? कोई भी क्वेश्चन है उसमें से सिक्स क्वेश्चंस हैं सब क्वेश्चंस, यू कैन डू थ्री क्वेश्चंस एंड दैट इज इनफ। यू डोंट हैव टू डू ऑल द सिक्स क्वेश्चंस। सो डू नॉट डू द सेम टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, डू ऑल्टरनेट क्वेश्चंस बट कंप्लीट एवरीथिंग। ओके, सो फंक्शंस में इफ यू डोंट हैव एनी डाउट्स देन वी प्रोसीड विद एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन और फर्स्ट वी डू फंक्शंस के डाउट्स। नो डाउट्स?
तो हम कल कर लें फंक्शंस के डाउट्स,
इफ यू
कल
हैव
कर
एनी,
लेते
यस वी
हैं.
कैन डू टुमारो बट डू नॉट मेक इट अ हैबिट टू डू इट लेटर ऑन। ठीक है,
ओके.
ओके, देन वी विल स्टार्ट विद एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन। एक्सपोनेंशियल्स डिस्कस करते हैं पहले एंड देन वी गो टू एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शंस। ओके, सो वी नो, वी हैव डन इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस दैट nth रूट ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर 1 बाय एन। यस, वी ऑलरेडी नो दिस, nth रूट ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर 1 बाय एन। तो यहां से वी कैन से दिस इंप्लाइज nth रूट ऑफ ए टू द पावर एम is equal to a to the power m upon n. Correct? Where m and n are integers. Then this is one result. Recall that we have studied laws of exponents also. Laws of exponents, which are a few of them I'm writing down. First important is a to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. If the base is same and a to the power m is multiplied by a to the power n, we can add the powers like this. Okay? Then second is a to the power m to the power n is equal to a to the power m into n. Third, if we have a to the power m upon a to the power n, this is equal to a to the power m minus n. Fourth, a to the power 0 is equal to 1. Ye kahan se aaya? How do you know that a to the power 0 is equal to 1? Any number to the power 0 is 1. Can you tell me how? No derivation? Nahi pata?
So we just know that this formula exists. We don't know the derivation.
हाँ, so derivation is quite simple. यहाँ से ही आया है, from the third one. If m is equal to n हो गया, if m is equal to n, तो यहाँ पे a to the power m upon a to the power m हो जाएगा on the left hand side, ठीक है? A to the power m upon a to the power m cancel, okay, it will be equal to 1. And right hand side में क्या हो जाएगा? A to the power m minus m, which is equal to a to the power 0. So we get 1 is equal to a to the power 0. Yahan se we get this result. Okay. Fifth one. If we have a to the power a into b to the power m. A into b to the power m. This is equal to a to the power m into b to the power m. Then last one. Is if we have 1 upon a to the power n, this is equal to a to the power minus n. Yes, ye sab yaad aa rahe? Able to recall everything? Right? Alright, so let's take some examples then. We'll use this formula and the laws of exponents. I'm taking some examples from your book. Oh, where is it? Give me a minute. I forgot my sheet.
Okay, sir.
Yes. Yes, okay. So I'm taking some examples from your book. Exercise 2A, question 1, I part. This is 1 upon cube root of 16 is equal to what? We have to write as a single power of 2. Cube root of 16. This is equal to 1 upon cube root of 2 to the power 4. 16 is 2 to the power 4. Now, yahan pe apply this formula. Nth root of a to the power m is equal to a to the power m upon n. So, yahan pe cube root of 2 to the power 4 is equal to 2 to the power 4 upon 3. Now, this will go.
So, my net is glitching. Can I reconnect in 2 minutes?
Yeah, connect first. Okay. I'm waiting.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Divyani, why is your video off?
So, गलती से हो गया.
Okay.
So you can begin.
Okay. All right. So this is equal to, if I take it in the numerator, power will become negative. So this is equal to 2 to the power minus 4 by 3. Another example, question 3, I part. Question 3, I part. In the form, write in the form a to the power k, where a is a prime number and k is rational. Question is 1 upon 7th root of 49. We have to write it in a to the power k form. So this is equal to 1 upon 7th root of 49, which is 7th root of 7 square. This is equal to, yahan pe ye wala formula lagayenge. So 7th root of 7 to the power 2 is equal to 7 to the power 2 by 7. We take this into numerator and we make this the numerator and we get 7 to the power minus 2 by 7. Correct? Very simple. Now, write without rational exponents. Question 6. Write without rational exponents. So, what we have to do is, in these examples, we were writing these forms into exponential, into exponents. Right? So, we have to write without rational exponents. So, we have to do the reverse process now. So if we have C part 3 to the power 5 upon 2, we have to write without rational numbers. So this is equal to 3 to the power 5. 3 to the power 5 kitna ho jayega? 3 to the power 5 is equal to, mentally karna hai. Everything mentally. 3 to the power 2 is equal to 9. Uski power 2 is 81, that is equal to 3 to the power 4. Into 3 karenge, to 3 to the power 5 aa jayega. So 81 into 3. 81 into 3 kitna hua? Yes, 81 into 3. Hey, itna time lagaoge kya? Kya kar rahe ho? 81 into 3 is 243. So 243 to the power 1 by 2 aayega. This is equal to square root of 243. This is without rational exponents. Then one more example. One last example I'm taking for this because this is quite simple. One more example, without using a calculator, write in simplest rational form. Simplest rational form. So we have 8 to the power minus 4 by 3. Isko simplest rational form mein likhna hai, matlab a to the power k, where a is prime, aisa kuch karna hai. Achha, rational form, I'm sorry. Rational form mein likhna hai. So again, we have to remove the exponents. So 8 to the power minus 4 by 3. This is equal to 1 upon 8 to the power 4 by 3. This is equal to 1 upon. Ab isko main aise likh raha hu. 8 to the power 1 by 3 to the power 4. Like this. 8 ka cube root ho jayega 2. So 8 to the power 1 by 3 is 2. 2 to the power 4 aayega. This is equal to 1 upon 16. This is in the rational form. Okay? All right. Now, this was about exponents.
So, these kind of questions will come in the non-cal paper, right?
Yes, of course. Isme calculator kahan pe use ho raha hai. But some might be coming in calculators also. In non, what was he saying? sorry, what is that word? Non-calculator paper.
Yes, sir. Paper one is non-cal, like non-GDP.
Yes. So these type of questions, which are in fifth, question fifth.
Yes, sir.
This might come as in a calc paper, as a question of calc paper. Because here the calculator is used and we have to write in three significant figures. So you get the value from the calculator and you just use three significant figures and uske form mein likhna hai, that's it. But all these types of questions will come as non-calculator questions. Why was it such a big concern, Ananya?
Sir, kyunki kabhi kabhi galat ho jata hai isme.
Isme kya galat hona hai? Isme everything is so clear here.
Paper ke time galat ho jata hai.
You are actually either thinking something else or you are not focused or your mind wanders off somewhere. Isliye galtiyan hoti hain. Otherwise, if you are focused, nothing, no mistakes will happen. So make sure that that is what happens. Galtiyan kam se kam karte raho. Everywhere. Even while speaking, that this is like how we learn mathematics, you have to be exactly 100% clear what is happening. Theek hai? Kisi ko koi cheez explain bhi kar rahe ho, jaise main kuch poochta hu, mujhe kuch bata rahe ho, so it should be very clear what you mean. It should not be anything confusing. Theek hai? Try to make that happen. That is the correct way of studying mathematics. So, yes. Some important identities that we use, algebraic identities that we use for simplification or factorization of expressions. I'm writing those down. Okay? Some important identities. So, book mein bahut kam de rakhi hai, which are very basic. I don't think I need to write them down again. You have already done all these kinds of identities. A into B to B plus C is equal to AB plus AC. Correct? A ko apan ne dono elements se multiply kar diya bracket ke. Dono terms se. Correct? Then A plus B into C plus D. Quite simple. A pehle C or D dono se multiply hoga. Phir B dono C or D se multiply hoga. Theek hai? We already know this. This is known as distributive law. Then A plus B whole square. This is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB. Then A minus B whole square is equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB. And A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B. Quite simple. Okay? But the most important and the... what should I say? Jo kabhi use nahi karte students. The most neglected part is that identities are true both the sides. So you can use both the sides of the identities everywhere. And you should be using them wherever necessary. So agar maine aise likha hai, AB plus AC, then you can write this as A into B plus C. So ulta use karna bhi aana chahiye identities ka. This is the most neglected part. Students don't use this. Okay? That's why they are stuck somewhere because they do not remember that you can use left hand side and right hand side both. Jaise ye to ye ho gaya, then AC plus AD plus BC plus BD. We have this. This can be written as A plus B into C plus D. ऐसे यूज करना भी आना चाहिए. Make sure that you know this. कैसे आएगा? I'm proving this identity from this side. वहां से तो कर ही सकते हो, A को C से मल्टीप्लाई करके एंड A को D से मल्टीप्लाई करके एंड देन सो ऑन. यहां से कैसे करेंगे? A कॉमन लिया मैंने फर्स्ट टू एलिमेंट, फर्स्ट टू टर्म्स में से. वी गेट A इंटू C प्लस D. प्लस B मैंने इन दोनों टर्म्स में से कॉमन लिया तो B इंटू C प्लस D आ गया. Then C plus D in dono terms mein se common lenge. then we get C plus D into A plus B. तो ये भी आना चाहिए. सिमिलरली ये भी पता होना चाहिए, ए स्क्वायर प्लस टू ए बी प्लस बी स्क्वायर. इसको हम लिख सकते हैं एज ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर. यहां से भी आना चाहिए कि आइडेंटिटी. यहां से कैसे अपन इसकी प्रूफ कर सकते हैं, हाउ कैन वी प्रूव एल एच एस इज इक्वल टू आर एच एस. सो वी कैन राइट दिस एज ए स्क्वायर प्लस ए बी plus so ab plus b square.
This is a part of the Pascal's triangle, right?
Which one?
The how to prove this, like in school you were taught we can do this by Pascal's triangle.
How? Can you tell me once?
So the first, so like we build it in the form of a triangle. So first is 1, then it's 1, 2, 1. Like you'll add the numbers, you'll keep the numbers on the sides equal, and then you'll add like the 2.
Yeah, the Pascal's triangle we'll be using in binomial theorem. We understand Pascal's triangle there.
वो तो जब हम like बहुत बड़ा होते हैं तब Pascal's triangle use करते हैं ना. Like for example, if you have 4 का, then Pascal's triangle comes into play ना. But 2 का तो बहुत छोटा हो जाएगा.
No, it comes into play everywhere. It is.
हाँ, but like for like usage, like यहाँ तो we can do it mentally because it's so
simple. Yeah, यहाँ पे Pascal triangle पढ़ने की भी ज़रूरत नहीं है. It is simple. वहाँ पे पैस्कल ट्रायंगल आता कैसे? NC0, NC1, NC2, वहीं से तो आता है. तो अगर ये पता है तो फिर
इनकी दिस थिंग कम्स फ्रॉम. आई वाज सेइंग दिस ओनली कि दिस फार्मूला इज देयर आल्सो.
या
वी स्टार्टेड इट देयर.
दिस इज एक्सपेंशन ओनली. सो अपन बायनोमियल एक्सपेंशन ही कर रहे हैं. देयरफॉर पैस्कल ट्रायंगल से अपने पास आ सकते हैं इसके कोएफिशिएंट्स. दैट इज करेक्ट. नाउ अब अच्छा, इसको ये करना आता है क्या? यहां से ये प्रूफ करना नहीं आता होगा. आई एम प्रीटी श्योर इस तरफ से एलएचएस से आरएचएस प्रूफ करना है. तो कैसे करते हैं? फर्स्ट वी स्प्लिट 2ab इनटू ab प्लस ab, ऐसे लिखेंगे. देन यहां पे मैंने a कॉमन लिया फर्स्ट टू टर्म्स में से, तो वी गेट a इनटू a प्लस b. इन दोनों टर्म्स में से प्लस b लिया कॉमन, वी गेट a प्लस b इन ब्रैकेट. नाउ a प्लस b कॉमन आ गया, a plus b into a plus b हो गया, a this is equal to a plus b whole square. Okay, so if you understood this, of course it is valid for a minus b also. A square minus 2ab plus b square is equal to a minus b whole square होता है. इसको भी ऐसे ही सॉल्व करेंगे to get RHS. Now you have to tell me how we can get from a square minus b square, how we can get a plus b into a minus b. Yes, you have 2 minutes.
So do we have to prove LHS is equals to RHS? Or
yes.
So kya karna hai?
You have to prove LHS is equal to RHS proceeding from LHS.
I'm done.
Okay, tell me how.
So firstly, because there is a square minus b square, what I did is I did a into a minus b into b. Then what I did is I combined the positive variables, which is a and b here. So I combined a plus b whole square into a minus b, and then the equation came.
What? How can we do this? What are you doing? ये क्या कर रही है? a into a minus b into b है, तो a और b a plus b लिख दिया. How did we get a plus b here?
नहीं नॉट लाइक दैट देन आई दिस थिंग ना सो लाइक आई ब्रैकेटेड देम
आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट यू हैव डन आफ्टर दिस
सो आफ्टर दैट व्हाट आई डिड इज आई फॉर्मड ब्रैकेट्स व्हाट आई डिड इज दैट आई डिड ए माइनस बी
हाउ हाउ डिड यू गेट ए माइनस बी यहां पे कैसे आया ए माइनस बी you can't take a minus b common from here and a plus b dusra ban jayega what is this ye kya ho raha hai
well to gaya
kuch bhi jugad laga rahe ho ekdam this is not how you do this yahan pe to make rhs we do this manipulation a square plus ab minus ab I write it like this Can I do this? Is this valid? I'm adding AB and yes. subtracting AB. So it is negligible. So this is equal to, now I take A common from first two terms. It becomes A into A plus B. I take minus B common from the second, from the last two terms. Then it becomes minus B into A plus B. Now I'm taking A plus B common from both the terms. And it becomes a plus b into a minus b. This is the proof. Is it clear? Yes. Okay. Now I'm writing few more identities that we'll be using. First is a plus b plus c whole square. This is equal to, if we have three terms and whole square of that, this is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. So square of every term plus 2 into two terms at a time. So a plus b plus c whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. You have to be 100% clear that if we get this, then you can write this in this form. We can write RHS is equal to LHS wherever necessary. ठीक है? ये तो याद हो जाता है that this is equal to this, but then we forget that this part is also equal to this part. So you can both use the identity both ways. Okay. Next identity is a plus b whole cube. Can you tell me what a plus b whole cube is?
Sir, ek baar likh ke should I tell you then, like so that.
क्या लिख के? नहीं, if you recall it, you do not have to write the whole thing. Do you recall it? Have you studied it?
So just a second.
Okay. अभी मैं दूंगा इस करने के लिए. I'm just asking you if you recall this. I'm giving you one more identity.
No, so I forgot it because we don't really we haven't done this in like school or like in other places, so I don't. Remember.
You haven't.
Like in the sense that maybe we have, but not really. So like it's never come like as a priority.
So is it a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube?
Yes, it is correct. That is correct. So a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube. Plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. That is correct. Okay. We can also write this as this is equal to. We take 3ab common from both these terms. Then I can write it as a cube. I am writing b cube first. A cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. Both these forms are important. Both of these forms are important. From here, we can write one more identity, a cube plus b cube. What is this equal to? A cube plus b cube. A cube plus b cube is equal to, from here, a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b.
Sir, I'm not sure, but I think you've done a little mistake. Achha, nahin, yeah, you haven't.
What?
So I read it wrong, nothing.
Okay, everything okay? All right. So a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. This is equal to a plus b, I'm taking common from both these terms. A plus b, I've taken common from both these terms. Then in the bracket, we'll get a plus b whole cube. A plus b cube hai, usme se a plus b common ha gaya, so we will be remaining with a plus b whole square. Whole square. So this will be a plus b whole square minus 3ab. Correct? A plus b whole square ko, if we open, it will be a square plus b square plus 2ab. And there is already minus 3ab here. So we will be getting a square plus b square minus ab. Both of these forms are important. Both the forms are equally important. Okay. Then similarly, if we have a minus b whole cube, this is equal to a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cube. This is equal to a cube minus b cube. I'm taking minus 3ab common from both these terms. So minus 3ab into a minus b. Both are equally important. From here, we can get the value of a cube minus b cube, which I'm taking as another identity. A cube minus b cube is equal to a minus b whole cube plus 3ab into a minus b. From this, we are taking a minus b common from both the terms. Then in the bracket, we'll get a minus b whole square plus 3ab. If I open a minus b whole square, it will be a square plus b square minus 2ab. Because there is already 3ab here, we will get a square plus b square plus ab. Both are important. Both the forms are important. Then next identity. Next identity. It is, if we have a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc. This is equal to a plus b plus c into a square. 1 minute. Yes. A square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca. Very important. I'm checking if I'm missing one identity. No. Okay. All right. If we can prove this identity very easily, if we proceed from the right hand side se prove karna bahut easy hai. We just have to multiply all the terms and then they cancel out and we get the LHS. ठीक है. बट इफ वी वॉन्ट टू प्रोसीड फ्रॉम LHS दैट इज वेयर द प्रॉब्लम कम्स. ठीक है, नो वन इज एबल टू गेट इट फ्रॉम LHS. कैन यू ट्राई टू गेट इट फ्रॉम LHS? We have to prove this identity from LHS. LHS is equal to RHS. No, given up already? At least try. Okay, I'll tell you. Now understand this very clearly what is happening. We are going from LHS to RHS. So LHS is equal to this part. Okay, I'm not writing it down again. We apply the formula of a cube plus b cube first. A cube plus b cube ka formula. I'm writing it up again here as capital A cube plus capital B cube is equal to a capital A plus capital B into a square plus b square minus ab. Should I write it in this form? No. We will not be using it this form here. We will write it as a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. Now, यहाँ पे a cube plus b cube है, so we will write it as वहाँ से देखो क्या होगा? It will be a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b, then c cube and minus 3abc come as it is. This is equal to, now this is the tricky part. Okay, what is happening? We will find a cube plus b cube of these two terms. A cube plus b cube of these terms. Okay.
I'm confused. Same. So.
What? Confused?
Yeah.
Why confused? We'll be taking this complete thing as A, meaning we are taking a small a plus b as capital A. Okay. And small c as capital B. We just treat a plus b as one term.
Got it.
Okay, we treat a plus b as capital A and we treat small c as capital B. Then apply this formula. What will we get is bracket ke andar a plus b hai. So yahan pe a plus b will be equal to small a plus small b plus small c. And there's cube of this. So we will put a cube here. So a plus b plus c whole cube. Yes or no? Ananya?
Sir, I am confused in the second step.
Second step confusing. Okay. So look here. We are taking this as capital A. Just a plus b, not cube. We are taking A is equal to A plus B. ठीक है, so this is A. यहाँ पे A plus B आ जाएगा bracket के अंदर and the whole cube of that bracket. So if I'm taking A plus B as capital A, तो bracket के अंदर A plus B आ जाएगा, small A plus B. Correct? And then I'm taking small C as capital B. तो ब्रैकेट के अंदर बी आ जाएगा, सो दिस इज कैपिटल ए प्लस कैपिटल बी विच इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी प्लस सी. अंडरस्टूड नाउ? माइनस, नाउ यहां पे वापस समझना है, ए प्लस बी प्लस सी होल क्यूब आ गया, नेक्स्ट टर्म विल बी थ्री इंटू कैपिटल ए, कैपिटल ए इज ए प्लस बी इंटू कैपिटल बी विच इज सी into a plus b. Again a plus b is small a plus small b plus small c. Then we copy these terms down, minus 3ab into A plus B, or rather than copying it, let's do one more thing here. Did you understand this? Divyani?
Yes, I too understood it.
This A cube plus B cube kar rahe hain iska. Then from these two terms, this term and this term, we are taking minus 3AB common. We are taking minus 3AB common. In the bracket, we'll get minus 3AB common here. So we'll get A plus B plus C in the bracket. Okay. Now, here, we are taking, look here, A plus B plus C is in this term. A plus B plus C is in this term. And A plus B plus C is in this term. So we are taking A plus B plus C common. In the bracket, we'll get A plus B plus C whole square. Which we open, we'll get A square plus B square plus C square plus 2AB plus 2BC plus 2CA. This is A plus B plus C whole square. Minus we will get here, minus 3 into A into C. So minus 3AC. Then minus 3 into B into C. So minus 3BC. And from here we have minus 3AB. This is in bracket. Declare. Okay. Now, this is done. We are all done. So this is equal to A plus B plus C. Since I have no place to write, I am not writing it down. You can see that this, from here, we can get RHS. A plus B plus C into A square plus B square plus C square as it is. Plus 2AB hai, minus 3AB hai, so we will get minus AB. Then we have plus 2BC, minus 3BC, so we get minus BC. And we have plus 2CA, minus 3AC, so we get minus CA. Which is equal to RHS. Yes, very important. No one knows. Even teachers don't know how to get it from light left hand side.
This is very difficult.
Huh?
This is difficult.
Yes, it's complex. Lot of variables.
The manipulation is important. How we manipulate the expressions, that is important. Okay, so I'm taking some examples here. Few examples. This is exercise 2B. Exercise 2B, question 2F part. Question 2F. X to the power half into x to the power 33 by 2 plus 2 into x to the power 1 by 2 plus 3 into x to the power minus 1 by 2. Very simple. Okay. I'm writing down the next step directly. X to the power half. Ko andar multiply karenge every term se inside the bracket. So we get x to the power half into x to the power 3 by 2. Since base are same, we add the powers. So x to the power half, x to the power 1 by 2 plus 3 by 2 ho jayega. Plus, second term kya hoga? 2 into x to the power half. Base are same, so x to the power 1 plus 1 by 2 ho jayega. Last term will be 3 into x to the power, sorry, I'm sorry, x to the power half hai. 3 into x to the power half into x to the power minus half. So that will be x to the power 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. This is equal to, now this is equal to 1 by 2 plus 3 by 2 is 4 by 2, which is 2. So x to the power 2 plus, yahan pe 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 1. So this is equal to 2x. Half minus half is 0. So this is equal to plus 3. Because x to the power 0 is 1. Okay.
So which exercise is this?
This is 2B.
So is it from the green book? Because I was finding it from the blue book.
Oh, acha. So you didn't. This is from the other book. Achha. Green one. I'm not sure which color it is because I haven't seen the color.
It would be green.
But this is the second book. Okay. Now, question three. Question three, K part. Question is 7 to the power x minus 7 to the power minus x whole square. We have to expand and simplify. So we use the identity a minus b whole square, which is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. So this is equal to 7 to the power 2x plus 7 to the power minus 2x minus 2 into a into b hoga. So 2 into 7 to the power x into 7 to the power minus x. So this is equal to 7 to the power 2x plus 7 to the power 2x minus 2x, which is equal to 1 upon 7 to the power 2x. यहाँ पे 7 to the power x into 7 to the power minus x है, base same है, the powers add हो जाएंगी, x minus x will be equal to 0, so this is equal to minus 2, simply. इसको भी denominator में लिखने की जगह, just we can write directly like this itself, 7 to the power minus 2x.
So we can we also solve this by taking 7 to the power x as a variable, like 7 to the power 2x as a variable.
Yeah, but you don't need to. We take that variable when we have to solve the equation, okay? So that we can solve the quadratic equation because it becomes a quadratic equation. But here we do not need to take it as a variable. No need here. Then question fourth, which is factorize. Question fourth, I part. 4 to the power n plus 1 plus 2 to the power 2n minus 1. We have to factorize this. So factors ke terms mein likhna hai. So we can write this as first term, we can write it as 4 to the power n into 4. So this is 4 into 4 to the power n. Yes? 4 to the power n plus 1 hai. This is equal to 4 to the power n into 4 to the power 1. So 4 into 4 to the power n plus second term will be 2 to the power 2n upon 2 ho jayega. So this is equal to 1 upon 2 into 2 to the power 2n. 2 to the power 2n ko bhi main likh sakta hu as 4 to the power n. 2 to the power 2 is 4 to the power n. Yes, this is equal to 4 to the power n common le liya. In the bracket, we'll get 4 plus 1 plus 1 upon 2. So we get factors 4 to the power n into 9 upon 2. This is factorized form. Okay. One more example of factorization. Question 6. B part. 3 to the power x whole square plus 3x minus 6. 3 to the power x whole square plus 3x, plus 3 to the power x minus 6, not 3x.
So I have a doubt.
Yeah.
In the fourth question, what was the question? Was it to, I didn't get the question.
Factorize.
Okay, got it, sir.
Even in this question, we have to factorize. Okay, so here we can take 3 to the power x as variable, but we do not necessarily need to. Okay, just imagine it to be a variable. We do not have to take it, say, suppose a. No need. Okay, directly, bas soch lo ki haan ye variable ki tarah treat kar sakte hain isko, and then proceed. No need to write it down and waste your time. So we treat this as a variable, say a. So ye a square plus a minus 6 ho gaya. Now it is just factorization. So we split the middle term such that add karne pe it comes to be equal to the middle term, and multiply karne pe it comes to be the multiplication of first and third term. So factorization bata sakte ho kya iska middle term ka kya split karna chahiye mujhe? How should I split the middle term? Multiplication should be equal to minus 6. Addition should be equal to 1.
2 and minus 3,
yes. So, 2 and minus 3 aega kya? No.
3 raised to the power x is equals to...
I'm just asking the split. It will not be 2 and minus 3. It will be plus 3 minus 2. Because there is positive here. So, this will be equal to 3 to the power x ka square plus 3 into 3 to the power x minus 2 into 3 to the power x minus 6. We are treating 3 to the power x as a different variable. Now, 3 to the power x common le lenge first two terms mein se. So we will get 3 to the power x plus 3. Yahan pe bhi 3 to the power x, sorry, yahan pe minus 2 common le lenge. So we will get 3 to the power x plus 3 into 3 to the power x minus 2. This is the factorized form. Yes, understood. ठीक है, simple factorization है जो अपन ने किया हुआ है काफी time in previous classes. Okay, then simplify. 7th question. Simplify 24 to the power k upon 9 to the power k. We have to simplify this. This is equal to 24 to the power k upon 9 to the power k. This is equal to 24 upon 9 to the power k. Aise likh sakte hain. Yes. Whole to the power k. Is anything getting cancelled? Yes. So we divide both of them by 3. So we get 8 upon 3 to the power k. This is simplified. Simple. Very simple. 8th mein se e part le raha hun. 8th question ka e part. Again, we have to simplify. 6 to the power n plus 12 to the power n upon 1 plus 2 to the power n. This is equal to, we can write 12 to the power n as 6 into 2 to the power n. So, 6 to the power n plus 12 to the power n ko maine likha, 6 into 2 to the power n. I can write it as 6 to the power n into 2 to the power n upon 1 plus 2 to the power n. Numerator mein se 6 to the power n common le liya. Bracket mein aega 1 plus 2 to the power n. Denominator is also 1 plus 2 to the power n. So this gets cancelled and this is equal to 6 to the power n only. Okay. Chalo. Enough examples. Let's move on. So you have to try these exercises, of course.
So I have a question. In this example, won't it be 6n plus 6n into 2? Why would it be 6n into 2n? Won't that be 12n square?
12 is equal to 12 to the power n is equal to 6 into 2 to the power n, right?
Yeah.
Ah, so this is equal to 6 to the power n into 2 to the power n. Law kya hota hai? A into b to the power n is equal to a to the power n into b to the power n. Yes or no?
Yeah, got it.
Then, yehi to likha hai maine yahan pe. Addition thodi ho jayega. Okay, then exponential equations. So exponential equations is quite simple. Exponential equations means those equations which have a variable as a part of the power, simply. Okay. So if a variable occurs as part of an exponent or a power, then it is known as an exponential equation. Simple. Important result is if a to the power x, if a to the power x is equal to a to the power k, then this implies that x is equal to k. So if the base on both the sides are the same, then we can equate the powers. Okay. If the base are same, then we can equate the powers on both the sides. I'm taking a few examples. This is exercise 2C. Exercise 2C, question 1, G part. 5 to the power x is equal to 1 upon 125. Then we have to solve for x. This implies 5 to the power x is equal to 1 upon 125 ko 5 ki power 3 likh sakte hain. This implies 5 to the power x is equal to 5 to the power minus 3. Now both the sides, the base is the same, which is 5. So we can equate the powers. So we get x is equal to minus 3. Another example. Solve for x, 16 to the power x is equal to 1 upon 32. This implies 16 ko main 2 to the power 4 likh sakta hun. So left hand side we get 2 to the power 4x is equal to 1 upon 32 ko I can write as 2 to the power 5. So this is equal to 1 upon 2 to the power 5, which is equal to 2 to the power minus 5. Now both the base, both the sides, the base is same, which is 2. So we equate the powers, we get 4x is equal to minus 5. So x is equal to minus 5 by 4. This is the value of x. Got it? Okay. Next example, one more. Question 5th, H part. 2 into 4 to the power x minus 5 into 2 to the power x plus 2 is equal to 0. We have to solve for x. Now, yahan pe 4 to the power x ko main 2 to the power x ka whole square likh deta hun. Yes, 2 to the power x ka whole square likh sakta hun main. Yes or no? Four to the power x can be written as 2x, 2 to the power x ka whole square. So minus 5 2 to the power 5 into 2 to the power x plus 2 is equal to 0. Now 2 to the power x can be treated as a variable, and then this becomes as a quadratic equation. It becomes a quadratic equation in the variable. Say I'm taking it as alpha. So it is a quadratic equation in alpha now. Theek hai? I'm not writing in terms of alpha. Again, main yahan pe alpha ki terms mein nahi likh raha hun. Directly split karte hain. So this is equal to 2 into 2 to the power x ka whole square minus. Ab kaise main split karun? So that multiplication is 4. And addition is equal to minus 5. addition is minus 5 and multiplication is 4.
So minus 2x minus 4x.
Minus 2 and minus 4 will become minus 6, not minus 5. Plus, additionally, dono ka multiplication.
Nahi, matlab plus 4.
Nahi.
So it needs to multiply into 4.
Khud batana. Dekho, dikh to raha hai saamne.
Sorry.
You should be aware of what it should be. Multiplication kya hona chahiye?
So the multiplication is 4 and the this thing addition is 5 na. So the minus 1 of minus 4 rahega to
galat hai yaar, kya hai dhang se, this is minus 5,
so minus 2 hoga na, minus 2 and minus 1 by 2.
No, minus 2 and minus 1 by
2. So agar minus 1 aur minus 4 hoga to uska into be 4 hoga, minus 1 minus 4.
So minus 1 and minus 4, that is correct.
So I said this before.
Minus 2 was said.
Oh, sorry.
Minus 2 minus and plus 4.
This is what I meant. I'm so sorry.
Very bad, Javgani.
Minus 4 and minus 1 hoga. Minus 4 plus minus 1 is equal to minus 5. And dono ka multiplication is plus 4. So minus 4 into 2 to the power x. Minus 1 into 2 to the power x. Plus 2 is equal to 0. Do not take the habit or do not make the habit of taking this as a variable. That you can do it directly. Variable se time kharab hoga. Then yahan se maine 2 into 2 to the power x common le liya. In the bracket we get 2 to the power x minus 2. Here we get 2 to the power x minus 2. Minus 1 common. So this is equal to 0. This implies 2 to the power x minus 2 into 2 to the 2 into 2 to the power x minus 1 is equal to 0. This implies 2 to the power x is equal to 2 or 2 to the power x is equal to 1 by 2. Because both are valid, dono values ho sakti hain. Yahan se aayega x is equal to 1 or yahan se aayega x is equal to minus 1. So both are valid. Either x is equal to 1 or either or x is equal to minus 1. Got it? Theek hai? Chalo, aage proceed karte hain. Exponential function which I wanted to tell you. Aaj karenge wo. All this was quite easy part. This I think you have already done this in 10th. If you had additional mathematics. So now we have exponential function, which also I think you have done in 10th, but I don't think you would have done it very well.
So the graph of exponential functions. Graph of exponential functions.
First we'll do the definition of exponential function, then we'll be doing the graph of exponential function. I think aaj apan sirf definition cover kar payenge, graph we'll be able to do in the next class only.
No problem.
So, definition of exponential function. Pehle exponential function kya hota hai, we'll see that. Give me a second. Okay, first I'm defining exponential function. So exponential function is defined as y is equal to a to the power x. Y is equal to a to the power x, where a is greater than 0, a is not equal to 1, and x belongs to all real numbers, to the set of real numbers. X belongs to the set of real numbers. This is the definition. ठीक है? यहाँ पे क्या है? Y is equal to a to the power x. This is the function. conditions are also important, very important actually, because domain and range nikalne mein ye kaam aati hain. They are very important. Conditions are A cannot be negative, neither can it be zero. So A has to be always positive. A cannot be one either. And X belongs to the set of real numbers, that is the domain. Okay? Now the important part which has been omitted from your book is why these conditions are there. This is an important part. कि ये conditions क्यों लगी हुई हैं यहाँ पे, ठीक है? ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है कि ये conditions होनी चाहिए तभी ये exponential function होगा. Nothing has been mentioned in your book, but it is very important. So we'll be discussing this.
Won't it be if a is equals to one, y would be equal to a whole number, like a natural number?
So if a is equal to one, तो वो one ही हो जाएगा. Y तो one ही हो जाएगा. Exactly one होगा. Not any other whole number. It will always be one.
Yeah. Okay? Huh.
Yeah. So we'll be coming back to that. क्योंकि a is equal to one हो गया. So y is always equal to 1, it becomes a constant function. And constant function is another type of function. इसलिए हम a को 1 नहीं लेते हैं, ठीक है? अभी यहाँ पे ये है कि a is known as the base. A is known as the base. Of course, we have already done exponents, तो वहां से भी पता होना चाहिए. And x is known as the exponent or the power. Or the index is plural. Now yahan pe ye conditions kyun hai, theek hai? So these conditions come from the fact that we choose a such that the function is defined for all real numbers, theek hai? So hum a ko aisa dete hain such that the function is defined for all real numbers. Okay, so first we see why a cannot be negative, why a is not negative. Theek hai, a is not negative because if maine suppose a ko -1 le liya, which is a negative number, and x ko maine half le liya, 1/2, then y becomes what? Then y is equal to root of -1, correct? अगर a माइनस वन हो गया, x हाफ हो गया, तो y इज इक्वल टू रूट ऑफ -1. नाउ बिकॉज y बिकम्स रूट ऑफ -1, रूट ऑफ -1 क्या है? दिस इज नॉट अ रियल नंबर, इट इज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, ठीक है? क्योंकि y एक कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर आ गया, द फंक्शन डज नॉट नो लॉन्गर रिमेन्स अ रियल फंक्शन, ठीक है? Though this is well defined, ऐसा मत बोलना कि ये well defined नहीं है. Root of -1 is well defined. It is equal to iota, which is a complex number. Because y is equal to a complex number, which is not real, therefore the function no longer remains a real function. इसलिए हम y a को negative नहीं लेते हैं. Therefore we do not take a to be negative. So that the function is defined for all real numbers. ठीक है? आ रहा है समझ में? Now why we do not take a to be equal to zero as well? If a zero हो जाता है, suppose a को मैंने zero ले लिया और x को मैंने -1 ले लिया, तब क्या हो जाएगा? y will be equal to 0 to the power -1, which is equal to 1/0, which is not defined. Yes, so y will not be defined when a is equal to 0 and x is equal to -1 or any other negative integer, negative number. That's why we do not take a to be equal to 0 also. We exclude 0 from the base. That's why A is always taken to be a positive number. ठीक है, so A is always a positive number because it cannot be negative also and it cannot be zero also. So that the function is defined for all real numbers. अब ये वाली condition क्यों आई? A is not equal to one. I already told you. If A is equal to one, Y will be equal to one because one to the power any number is always equal to one. A to the power positive number is also one. A to the power negative number is also one. A to the power zero is also one. So if A is equal to one, Y will be equal to one, which is a constant function. Therefore, we do not take A to be equal to one. We exclude one from the base as well. Is this clear? Yes, sure. Okay. So I am repeating again. Y is equal to a to the power x is the exponential function where a is greater than zero, meaning a is always positive. A is not equal to one, and x belongs to the set of real numbers. So real numbers is the domain. ठीक है, यहाँ पे a negative क्यों नहीं लेते हैं? क्योंकि suppose a मैंने minus one ले लिया, x half ले लिया, तो y will become root of minus one, which is a complex number. The function no longer remains a real function. That's why we exclude all negative numbers from the base. A is not equal to zero also because a zero हो गया, x minus one हो गया, तो y is equal to one upon zero, which will not be defined. इसलिए हम a को zero भी नहीं लेते हैं. A को हम one भी नहीं लेते हैं because तब वो constant function बन जाएगा and exponential function नहीं रहेगा. तो हम one को भी exclude करते हैं. ठीक है? These are the conditions and why they occur. So range क्या हो जाएगा इसका? Range is equal to what? A positive number raised to the power of positive number will always be positive. Yes or no? कोई भी positive number लिया, उसकी power हमने positive ले ली, so it will always be a positive number.
Greater than zero.
Can you repeat? Range is?
Range should be y is greater than zero.
Just greater?
Equal to.
Equal to आएगा?
हाँ
हाँ. Sure.
Yeah, I guess.
I guess नहीं. Sure हो तो अब तो बता. Think it through. वापस पूरा सोच. If it will be equal to zero or not. Yes, Ananya.
So, शायद.
शायद क्या? शायद आएगा या शायद नहीं आएगा? Zero.
आ सकता है.
किस value पे आएगा zero बताना?
One.
है? किसकी power क्या? X की value one या A की value one?
की value one.
A की value one पे तो सारी values ही one हो जाएगी ना? Y will be one. A की value तो one हम ले ही नहीं रहे domain base के लिए.
So X की value one.
X की वैल्यू वन. X की वैल्यू वन के लिए जीरो कैसे आएगा? एनी नंबर टू द पावर वन इज इटसेल्फ. तो या तो जीरो ही लें, और जीरो अपना बेस नहीं हो सकता है. सो रेंज इज y इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो ओनली, नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो. y इज ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव. ठीक है, quite easy to understand. Any positive number to a power of positive number will be positive. Any negative number, sorry, negative to hi nahi sakta. Any positive number to the power of negative number will also be positive, kyunki wo denominator mein chala jayega and it will be still positive. Jaise aisa ho gaya 5 to the power minus 2, this is equal to 1 upon 5 to the power 2, again it is a positive number. And any positive number to the power 0 is always 1, which is also positive. So range is greater than 0. Y is always greater than 0. ठीक है दिव्यानी क्या हुआ योर वीडियो इज फ्रीज्ड
सर आई वाज राइटिंग डाउन समथिंग
क्या
सर आई वाज राइटिंग द रेंज वाला थिंग दैट्स व्हाई
ओके ऑलराइट सो रेंज इज वाई इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो ऑलवेज ठीक है लेट्स सी द ग्राफ ग्राफ ऑफ एन एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन Now the graph will depend on the value of a. ठीक है? The graph will depend on the value of a. If a is greater than 1, अगर base 1 से बड़ा हो गया, then graph will always of the function is always a increasing function. ठीक है? If a is greater than 1, then the function is a increasing function. For example, यहीं पे समझते हैं, नहीं यहाँ पे graph आएगा, यहाँ पे लिखता हूँ. For example,
my laptop has only 3% battery, so I might just get disconnected in like 2-3 minutes.
Can't you put a charger?
So there's no socket near me.
Change your position then.
Okay, so I'll do that.
This is an important part. Don't miss out.
Okay, so I'll do that.
Yeah, put a charger somewhere. Devyani, kya ho raha
hai? Oh, my mom called.
Okay, acha. That's okay. All right. Ananya, are you in class?
Yes, I am.
Okay. So, if a is greater than 1, तब function increasing function होगा, ठीक है? For example, अपन ऐसा ले लेते हैं, base मैंने 1 से ज़्यादा ले लिया, suppose 2 ले लिया, and I'm increasing x. So, 2 की power 2, 2 की power 3, 2 की power 4, like this, ठीक है? So, I'm increasing x 2, 3, 4 and so on. तो y की वैल्यू में क्या आ रहा है y की वैल्यू भी इंक्रीज हो रही है बिकॉज 2 टू द पावर 3 इज ग्रेटर देन 2 टू द पावर 2 2 टू द पावर 4 इज ग्रेटर देन 2 टू द पावर 3 सो एज x इज इंक्रीजिंग y इज आल्सो इंक्रीजिंग ठीक है सो द फंक्शन इज एन इंक्रीजिंग फंक्शन व्हेन दिस इज ट्रू व्हेन a इज ग्रेटर देन 1 सो द ग्राफ ऑफ एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन इज लाइक दिस This is the graph of y is equal to a to the power x when a is greater than 1. Y-intercept will be 1. We can see the nature of the graph like this as well. As x tends to plus infinity, tab kya hoga? Y which is equal to a to the power x. Theek hai? A अगर greater than 1 है, A अगर greater than 1 है, तो that number to the power infinity will always be tending towards infinity. It will tend towards infinity. So y tends towards infinity plus infinity as x tends towards plus infinity. Yes? आ रहा है क्या समझ में? ठीक है यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है a 1 से बड़ा है तो अगर मैं x को इंक्रीज करूंगा तो a टू द पावर x भी इंक्रीज होगा ठीक है सो y विल टेंड टुवर्ड्स प्लस इंफिनिटी एज x टेंड्स टुवर्ड्स माइनस इंफिनिटी तब क्या हो रहा है एज x टेंड्स टुवर्ड्स माइनस इंफिनिटी y व्हिच इज इक्वल टू a टू द पावर x इट विल बी इक्वल टू a टू द पावर माइनस इंफिनिटी This is equal to 1 upon a to the power infinity. A to the power infinity will tend towards infinity. So y is equal to 1 upon infinity. So y will tend towards 0 plus. 1 upon infinity hai. So it will tend towards 0 but with a positive sign. So y will tend towards 0 plus. यहाँ से ग्राफ से भी अपन देख सकते हैं as x is tending towards plus infinity, y is also tending towards plus infinity. As x is tending to minus infinity, y is tending towards zero plus. ठीक है, तो zero, y is equal to zero will be a horizontal asymptote because y is equal to zero meets the curve at infinity. Y is never equal to zero but tending towards zero. ठीक है, so y is equal to zero is the horizontal asymptote. Understood? आगे प्रोसीड करें. Okay. So the graph of the function, if a is between 0 and 1, तब क्या होगा? If a is between 0 and 1, the graph of the function is a decreasing function. The function is a decreasing function. If a is between 0 and 1, तो function is a decreasing function. जैसे मैंने a की value 1/2 ले ली. So what is happening? If I'm taking 1/2 and I'm increasing x, so 1/2 to the power 2, 1/2 to the power 3, and 1/2 to the power 4. y की वैल्यू क्या हो रहा है? y is equal to 1/2 to the power 2, 1/2 to the power 3, 1/2 to the power 4. क्या हो रहा है? y की वैल्यू इंक्रीज हो रही है या डिक्रीज हो रही है?
सो डिग्री में क्या बोला
अभी? अरे यार, सुना तो करो. तो लिखने पे इतना फोकस मत किया करो. हाँ, फर्स्ट लिसन टू व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, वो ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट है. हाँ, डिक्रीजिंग हो जाएगा अगर x को मैंने इंक्रीज किया. यहाँ पे 2 लिया है, फिर 3 लिया है, फिर 4 लिया है, मतलब आई एम इंक्रीजिंग x. y की वैल्यू में क्या हो रहा है? दिस इज इक्वल टू 1/4, दिस इज इक्वल टू 1/8. व्हिच वन इज बिगर?
1/2 to the power
2. 1/4 is bigger than 1/8, so this is bigger than this. Similarly, ये 1/8 है, ये 1/16 हो जाएगा. This is bigger than this. तो x को तो मैं increase कर रहा हूँ, but y is getting decreased.
हाँ.
ठीक है. So जब base 0 and 1 के बीच में है, the function is a decreasing function. ठीक है. Graph कैसा बनेगा? Graph will be a decreasing curve. So graph is like this. यहाँ पे ये meet नहीं कर रहा है, maybe लग रहा होगा. थोड़ा सा ज्यादा पास में बना दिया मैंने. Like this. Of course increase भी नहीं कर रहा है वापस. Yes. This is y-axis, this is x-axis. So the graph is a decreasing graph curve now. So x ko agar main increase kar raha hu, to y ki value decrease ho rahi hai. Yes? Theek hai?
Yes, sir.
If we look at the nature of the graph, let's discuss that. As x tends towards plus infinity, tab y kya ho jayega? Y will be equal to a to the power infinity. A क्योंकि 0 से 1 के बीच में है, A क्योंकि 0 से 1 के बीच में है, तो a to the power infinity will tend towards 0. So y मतलब 0 की तरफ जाता रहेगा, छोटा होता रहेगा. ठीक है. So y will tend towards 0 plus. क्या ये समझ में आया? This time a is between 0 and 1. So a to the power infinity will tend towards 0 because it will keep decreasing. So it will tend towards 0. As x tends towards minus infinity, tab y is equal to a to the power minus infinity. This is equal to 1/a to the power infinity. A to the power infinity will tend towards 0 plus. So y will tend towards 1/0 plus, which is y tends towards plus infinity. वो ही यहाँ पे हो रहा है. As x is tending towards plus infinity, y is going towards 0 plus. And x is tending towards minus infinity, y is tending towards plus infinity. Y intercept is again 0, 1. this is the graph when a is between 0 and 1. आगे समझ में?
Yes.
Okay. I'm just looking if I've missed anything. In this case also, y is the horizontal, y is equal to 0 is the horizontal asymptote in this case as well. Because y is tending towards 0 plus. So in both the cases, x-axis is the horizontal asymptote. This is the definition of exponential function and the graph.
Got it.
Yes. So transformation of graph, jo ki kafi major portion hai tumhare chapter mein, we will be doing that in the next class. Okay, transformation of graph. And of course, transformation hi sirf time nahi lega, so we'll probably be doing growth and decay as well. So
growth aur decay mein kafi confusion hai.
काफी कंफ्यूजन है ठीक है
हाँ लाइक मैंने एग्जाम मैंने एक बार टेस्ट में क्या कहा था कि आई थिंक डीके दिखाना था और वहां लाइक डीके का फॉर्मूला में जब एन ऊपर डालते हैं तो एक बार कभी कभी एन होता है कभी कभी एन माइनस वन होता है डिपेंडिंग ऑन द ईयर या टाइम और लाइक द प्रोग्रेशन का तो उसके अंदर मैंने काफी बार मेरी गलती हो जाती है तो मेरे को उसमें काफी डर
ठीक है So it's not a major thing. It will be clear next time. ठीक है? बहुत ही simple है growth and decay. कुछ भी ज़्यादा मुश्किल नहीं है.
और जो exam में question आया था, that's not understandable. तो that's a topic that has a little confusion. Like थोड़ा
different. Which one? Growth and decay.
Growth and decay. Yeah.
What was the problem?
So question मतलब we got the question कि हो क्या रहा है question में increase हो रहा है वो उसके साथ replicate हो रहा है उसकी growth हो रही है bacteria की but उसके बाद there was like some 1000 to the power x and then they were subtracting
so basically we had नहीं वो fish pond का था ना the number of fish
हाँ मतलब जो
we had to talk about the like it was a non-calculator paper so explaining how it will be done Like the whole we had to calculate for like a lot of years, like I think at least 12 years. So, uska aur bina calculator ke thoda problem.
So basically, it was lengthy and a little confusing.
Yeah.
I think the problem was not in the question growth of decay, because you are able to understand that growth happens when we are increasing things, and decay happens when they are decreasing, right? But the question, the problem might be in the transformation of graph part. Because if you have 10,000, matlab 1000 se multiply ho raha hai, the exponential function is in the form which you have to first transform and then you have to make the graph and then you have to find the value of something from that graph. I think that might be the problem. But I'm pretty sure ki clear ho jayega ekdam 100% jab apan karenge discuss.
Okay,
sir. Okay, sir. Thank you.
So don't worry. Okay. That's it for today. Kal continue karenge. Theek hai?
Thank you, sir.
Yes. Okay.